Is there anyone on the show that we should be trusting at this point?
No, not really.
Really not.
I mean,
the show deals in secrecy and duplicity. Yeah, and that's part of the beautiful dialectic of the show. Like, what you see is not what you get.
Right.
Right. It's all about enigma. It's all about covering. You know, you guys just saw episode 5, right?
Yeah.
Where you see Campbell through hallucinations, and then at towards the end of the episode, you see him in an extreme close-up get down next to the spindle that's been painted over.
Great.
To me, that's a perfect image of the show.
Oh.
The family has painted over the cracks in their bedrock, and as the next episodes unfold, the paint gets chipped away. Really satisfying.
Oh, interesting.
And that's exactly what we, in the writer's room, wanted, that image that we'll say, well, yeah, beautiful and perfect. And you know, we feature that staircase in every episode purposely because we knew we were building to that.
It's like a loaded gun, right?
Yeah,
you have a staircase in a series of something.
And if someone's not, something's not going to happen there. And so, that's just the beginning of it. So we'll really follow that through. It's a critical part of the whole family's backstory, that staircase. And so that's the one close-up image of the cracks in the veneer and the evidence of actual, you know, destruction or something. Something happened. What he thought was a hallucination was, in fact, a memory. So perception versus reality is obviously one of our key themes of the show. And it's something that we all know.
And you're right. I think you could wager at Tessa that she's loyal. But loyalty is different than trust. I mean, I think
the
next few episodes really explore those themes.
You mentioned in the past that they have broad strokes and story figured out at this point. But have you guys felt like they're taking liberties in the writing room in terms of coming up with spontaneous moments and say, okay, well, this is good, we should include it in this episode? Or are you still constrained to the overall arc?
At this exact moment, it's pretty done. It's all written, it's done.
Right. We're filming the finale right now.
Right.
Oh. Awesome.
But throughout the season, we absolutely, it was helpful to have an end game and have a blueprint of the entire season and the arc and what's going to happen overall and have it. Because it's all woven together in one tapestry, so if you change one thing in episode 4, you have to track it through the whole thing. So it was a puzzle, difficult at times puzzle. But once we had that infrastructure in place, then you get to go in and play. And what I love most about the show is less the, I love the mystery, but the moments that we get to go away from it for a moment and just live with people as human beings, apart from what they're grappling with in that moment, is really fun too. Because there's such an incredible cast, and they feel like a real family.
I have to brag about Corinne too, because she's such a collaborative creator that all the cast members have sent probably hundreds of emails back and forth because we're advocating for these people. So we feel very personally and passionately about what they say and what they do.
What they wear. All of it. We talk about all of it. We build the characters together.
I've never worked with such a capricious leader who has the generosity and also the strength, frankly, the character, to open up the story to the actors in such a way and allow them to be storytellers.
It's a push-pull because I wouldn't tell the answer. I wouldn't give anybody the answer. I was very much involved with that. But
she's been tight-lipped.
But I appreciated the investment. I really appreciate the investment and the level of investment and the passion to say, can I invert these two words? It feels better to me this way. I love that someone cares enough to ask me that. Absolutely. If that's what feels organic to you, that's what the character should say.
It just makes a better product at the end of the day.
Yeah,
you're right. Absolutely. You're right.
Absolutely. So it's all in service of the show. So, yeah.
That kind of collaboration can really kind of evolve the show as well.
I mean, yes.
How's it changed from the initial idea which you had, and how's it the eventual show? I mean, has there been much in terms of how it's changed from that original idea?
Yeah, I would say, I mean, when I originally conceived the show and pitched the show, it was really about a family in crisis and the disintegration of that family unit and how they rebuilt in the wake of this revelation. It really became much more of a classic whodunit, and that became the driver of every episode, and those cliffhangers became the driver. But I really wanted to make sure that we were preserving the character work that was always intended within that structure.
That kernel was the idea.
Yeah.
So for us, that's what makes a story interesting to tell. You know, let my character think, let my character feel, let my character discover that we're not just serving a whodunit plot. You know, just like a painting, frankly, there's a foreground and a background, and the background is sometimes more important to the composition of the painting. way. So she has such a depth of digression in the story. It's always sort of winding and meandering, and then suddenly, bam, something happens. And I think for a sophisticated audience like yourself, that makes it worth watching.
Yeah. Did the actual answer to the whodunit, was it the same from the very beginning of the series to what you wrote for finale?
Yes,
it was.
It was the same. It was,
and I know who.
The way that the twists and turns evolved over the season, you always find you need a few more little turns than you ever normally anticipate. So we always talk about it, it's like on the panel, that you end up pushing story left. I found this on every show I've ever worked on, that you think you've got enough for 5 acts or 6 acts, and really you've got enough for 2 acts, so you're always generating more story. So that's what evolves naturally in the writer's room. What are the many ways that we can layer this and pivot this? But we were always coming